Save 22 is a nonprofit organization dedicated to raising awareness about suicide prevention among vets and first responders. Tom Indorf is the founder of Save 22. He is here with Tom Petras and Nick Novak, the two groups that are working together now to put on this event that's coming up this weekend. And first of all, gentlemen, thank you very much for stopping in this morning to talk about the event. Before we jump into what's happening this weekend, let's just talk about the issue, let's talk about the problem. How prevalent is suicide among veterans and first responders?
Well, with the veterans, we have a number of 22 a day, which that's a general number that the VA throws out. The number is actually higher. It rose during COVID. It's a serious problem. I talk to veterans daily that struggle.
Talk about the issues. You know, what brings all this about?
It's the PTSD, mm-hmm. which leads to drug addictions, alcohol, just numerous. It causes marital problems, and these veterans, these first responders, they get caught with their own. We call them the demons in their heads.
The demons.
Mm-hmm. We have one of our logos is a skull we call Damien, and he's the demon that lurks over your shoulder.
It seems like we're hearing more and more about it these days, you know, with Desert Storm and all of that, the most recent wars. But was it a problem when the men came back and the women came back from Vietnam?
I believe it was. I think it's been around for a long time, with just no awareness of it. Mm-hmm. You know, now people are starting to see and are starting to understand what PTSD is, mm-hmm. and how traumatic it is. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Well, let's talk about the event this weekend. This is the second year for it, right?
Yes, these guys have put this event on. Last year, they were able to raise a little over $10,000 for us, and that goes a long way with our programmings. I'll let these guys talk.
What would the $10,000 be used for?
So $10,000 in Save 22's, that's 10 charter fishing trips that we would take veterans on. That's 10 trips to a racetrack. We take veterans to NHRA.
How does that stuff help?
It gets them out of their what's going on. It takes their mind off of what's going on, and it gets veterans talking to other veterans.
The camaraderie.
Okay. You know, and that's important.
And you know what? You're with brothers, guys that you've served with, or you may not have served together, but. You both served about the same time. It's a good thing.
What's happening this weekend? What are you guys going to do this weekend?
This weekend we have the VetFest second annual. We're going to have 5-6 bands playing.
Okay.
There's stuff for the kids to do when they come out.
So not just veterans. Anybody can show up.
Yeah,
right?
Anybody.
Anybody.
And their families and stuff like that. Got stuff for the kids, as you mentioned.
Yes.
Yeah.
So I mean, our head. It's Creed Fisher. He'll be
our headliner.
Okay.
So.
So you got a financial goal this year? What do you guys plan to raise? What are you hoping to raise this year?
As much as we can.
As much as you can, huh?
Yeah.
What's the solution to this? How can we kind of alleviate this from happening with our men and women who serve?
I think the best thing is let the veterans know that we're here for them.
Get them talking. Get him talking to other veterans.
What's it like when you come back home from war? I mean, you know, that sparks something like this, PTSD.
I think it's a loss of brotherhood at first.
Yeah.
That feeling alone.
Yeah.
And not coming to terms. I know for a long time I didn't feel like a veteran. Because when I thought of a veteran, I thought of the guy with the old guy with the hat, you know,
Even though you served.
Even though I served.
Yeah.
At first I didn't. And it took a while to realize.
It takes a while to embrace it.
Yeah, to erase what you've gone through and all of that. Huh? Yeah. Well, kudos to what you guys are doing. You know, helping your brothers and sisters. Yeah. That's a beautiful thing. And once again, it's going to take place tomorrow. It's going to be tomorrow, the second annual Vet Fest, tomorrow from noon until 11 p.m. So it's an all-day event.
Right.
All-day event. And it's going to take place at the North Ridge, Victory Sports Park in North Ridgeville. Yes. And so it's, like I said, all day, just come, have a good time, and just, you know, show our former men and women in uniform that we care. that we love you guys and we thank you so much for your service.
And you know, tickets for it are only $22.
Oh, I didn't know. $22 to get in?
$22.
Okay,
and
okay.
It's a fantastic thing. Kids 17 and under are free.
Yeah.
You know, it's like you got a $100 bill, you can take the whole family out for the day.
That's right.
And that $100 can save a life.
And the money goes to help veterans.
Yep.
And first responders, that's the key.
Yes. Yeah.
Keep doing what you're doing, brother.
Thank you.
Appreciate you, man. Thank you guys for your service, man. Bless you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.